Hey Google, turn on studio lights.
Getting things set up for the shoot.
Hey guys, this is Steve, and today I'm going to show you how to automate your studio lights using a combination of IFTTT, Stringify, and some smart switches. So here we go. So first of all, anything I talk about in this video is going to be linked down in the description if you want to check that out. And also, there may be easier ways. Actually, there are easier ways to go about doing this. I did it with two different switches, and I didn't have a smart home hub, and they didn't have direct compatibility with Google Home. So I had to find a way around that. You can make this easier by using the same type of switches and or getting one of those smart home hubs. I didn't want to spend any additional money on that, so this is a way to do that on the cheap, and it's using IFTTT and Stringify. All right, so what are IFTTT and Stringify? These are both services that link into other services and hardware vendors that let you take an action and cause a reaction. IFTTT stands for if this, then that. So it's basically basic programming. There's one if statement, one then statement. So there's an action, one action, that causes one reaction. Stringify, on the other hand, you can have one action with modifiers, and then you can take multiple reactions on that. So that one request causes multiple actions. You can trigger multiple devices, multiple services. The problem with Stringify is that it works with the iHome switch, but it doesn't work directly with the Wemo switch. So I needed a way to kind of marry these together, and that's what I'm going to show you today. All right, so this is a little complicated, so I wanted to give an explanation here. So we're trying to give a command and to turn on the lights, and then the lights are going to go on. So turn on the lights go on. So we have IFTTT, and we can link that up to our Google Home, right? And we can tell it, turn on the lights, and then it's going to turn a light on. Good, easy, right? Problem is, we don't have a light, we have two lights, so we can't really do that. We can do something similar with Stringify, and we can link that to our Google Home as well, and then we can tell it, turn on the lights, and then in the flow of Stringify, we can tell it to turn on the iHome and turn on the Wemo. Now, the problem with that method is Stringify works with the iHome, does not work directly with the Wemo switch. Can't do that either. So what are we going to do? We're going to do a little hybrid. We are going to take this connection from IFTTT hooked to our Google Home, and we're going to call Stringify that lets you have two conditions. So that's going to be our new that. So if we call this on Google Home, then we're going to call this project on Stringify. Now we know that Stringify doesn't work with Wemo, but it works with iHome, so we can't call that directly. So what are we going to do? We are going to call back to IFTTT because IFTTT does work with both iHome and Wemo. So we're going to do that, and then we're going to make one turn on the iHome and one turn on the Wemo, and we're good to go. We are golden at that point. All right, so here's our hybrid. We're going to use IFTTT connected to Google Home. The results of that are going to call out to Stringify. This is our if this, then that. The Stringify is going to say, when IFTTT calls me, I'm going to trigger these back to IFTTT and trigger these other flows. One is going to turn on the iHome switch, and one is going to turn on the Wemo switch. And now, I'm going to show you how to do that, and we're going to start in Stringify. So the workflows in Stringify are called flows. Now, before we can start editing a flow, we got to make sure that we have the IFTTT connector. And anything that is a trigger or an action in Stringify is known as a thing. So if you don't already have the IFTTT, you just hit the plus up here, and you go and search. This is a long list of things that it works with. You find IFTTT in there, bam, you tap on it, it adds it, you're good to go. And then we can go back here and start editing our flow. So go into flows, and as you can see, I have an office lights on and studio lights off. We need two flows because one command is gonna turn everything off, and then one command is gonna turn everything on. So obviously, you're not going to have these in here, so just go ahead and create a new flow, It's going to walk you through this. All right, so we're in our first flow, and flows basically consist of triggers and actions. So first thing we need is a trigger. We're going to hit this plus, and we're going to select the IFTTT, because remember, we're going to be calling into the Stringify flow from IFTTT. We're just going to drag that up to one of the available circles, drop it, and you can see this gear pop up. We need to go into the gear, and this is going to be our trigger, so we need to make sure trigger is selected, and we click on configure, and it's going to grab this ID. We need to make sure that we remember that ID. You can always come back into Stringify if you forget it later and tap on the action, and it'll show you what the ID is. But we're going to need that when we set it up in IFTTT. So that is our trigger. So now we need the actions, and we're just going to drag this across to one of the other available slots, let it go. And remember, with this Stringify, we're going to be calling out to IFTTT again. So we drop that, it comes up with the gear again, and this is going to be our first action. So this is going to call on the IFTTT side to either turn on the iHome or the Wemo switch in this case. Need to make sure action selected, and then click on the configuration thing, and it gives you the ID, so we'll need to know that ID as well. Now that's going to turn on either the Wemo or the iHome, so now we just drag the next one over to do the other switch. We're going to select IFTTT again. It comes up with the gear. Select that. Make sure action selected. Run an IFTTT applet. It's going to get the ID, and we're going to save it. And that's all we need for the Stringify flow. We got IFTTT is going to be calling in. We're going to be calling out to two different flows. Now the only thing we have left to do is to tap the menu here and enable that flow. Successfully enabled. We can close out. And now we are done in Stringify. Don't forget, that's going to be one to either turn on or off the lights. You need to create the other one to do the opposite. So let's go into IFTTT now. All right, so here we are in IFTTT. We're going to go into applets. All right, now before we can add an applet, we need to add some services. So let's look at our diagram here. So we're going to need a few different services because we are going to connect to Google Home. All from IFTTT, we're going to connect to our Google Assistant, we're going to connect to Stringify, we're going to connect to iHome, and we're going to connect to Wemo. So we need to add those four services, Google Assistant, Stringify, iHome, and Wemo. And the way you add services is really easy. You just go into the Services tab, and this you can do all this on the website too, unlike Stringify. And iHome's right there. All you do is you tap on it, you go into the gear, set it up for your account, and then you come back and you find the next thing, you know, like Stringify. Once you get those four created, then you're ready to create your applet. Now, creating these applets is really easy. You just got to keep the flow in mind. So we are going to have three applets for each of these, right? So we're going to have, and when I say each of these, I mean for turning on the lights and turning off the lights. So one of them, we're going to issue a command from Google Home to say turn on the lights. It's going to call up the Stringify and then back to IFTTT to connect to iHome and Wemo to turn on the lights. And then the next one, turn off the lights. We're going to have that same flow for the off. So we're going to need 1, 2, 3 for on and 1, 2, 3 for off with Stringify sitting in the middle there. So let's go ahead and create those. Create a new applet. Again, really simple. If this, we need to create this first. And in this case, this is the one that we're going to be issuing the command from Google Home. So we need to connect to our Google Assistant. And we can say a simple phrase. There's a bunch of options. This is the one we're going to use. So I already have one that says turn on studio lights. So I'm just going to call this set up studio. And then this is pretty cool because then you can have the Google Assistant respond to that command, and you can do a custom response. Let's say okay, and then you create your trigger. So that's the if this, right? That's the this. Then we have to do the that. So this, when the Google command comes in, we're going to call out to Stringify. So let's do that. We're going to add Stringify now. And we're going to run a Stringify flow. Now it's connecting because we already connected this to our account. It's connecting to the flows. And if you notice, it has a bunch of IDs here, right? So this is where those IDs come in. This is our test flow. And if we look at this trigger, FTRY, so this is how we ensure that we're calling the correct flow. So the test ID, first part is the flow name, the second part is the trigger. So this is the one we want. So we're going to create that action. And that's it. So if we say setup studio, then it's going to call out to Stringify and run this flow. Now, right now, it's not going to do anything because we didn't tell it what these two actions are going to do. And that's the part we're going to do now. And now we're ready to create our two applets to turn on the lights. So we are going to go in and create a new applet. And now this time, this is going to be where we have Stringify calling back to IFTTT. So the trigger here, the this, is going to be Stringify. So then we have the same setup here. We have our test flow that we created, and we have those two IDs. So it doesn't really matter which one you use, but those two IDs correspond to the IDs that are in the actions that we added previously. So we can just select one, and we're going to create that trigger. And then that, we're going to add it to our Eevnos switch. Turn it on. And I only have one of these switches. If you had multiple switches, it would show them here. I'm going to create that action. All right, so there we go. So now we have our first action, and that was for the Eevnos switch. So looking back again, we have the one, you know, we have this branch, we have the Google Home. It's going to call out to Stringify, then it's going to call back to IFTTT and set up the turn on the Wemo. Now we have to create this branch, which is just the matter of creating that other applet. All right, so we have our three triggers set up. This is just to turn on the lights again. So if we look at this, we have the one for the Google Assistant. So when we call out to our Google Home and say set up the studio, it's going to run this, and then it's going to trigger our action in this flow in Stringify. And then once that's triggered, it's going to call out to those two IFTTT applets, and coming back here, which are these two, the one for the Wemo switch and the one for the iHome, and it's going to trigger that and turn those lights on. So to turn it off, we need to do the same thing. We set up our command so we could say, you know, like turn off studio, and then we set up the two flows the same way, except instead of turning the light on, we're going to turn it off. And that is all you need for method one of this setup. All right, guys, so that's all there is to it. Now, I know it sounds a little bit complicated in this tutorial, but I promise you, once you get in there and start doing it, it's really not as bad as it seems. And you can use these techniques for other things that IFTTT and Stringify support, not just the home automation stuff. But I hope you guys found this useful and informative. If you did, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't subscribed already. I do tutorials like this as well as technical reviews and pretty much anything tech related. So if you like that kind of stuff, please subscribe and come see me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. I love meeting new people on there and chatting with them as well. And I will see you in the next video.